In the light of Quran, and as you know, in this silsila, Mufti Sahab is always with us, and we discuss some particular verses of Quran, and then Mufti Sahab grants us Madani pearls regarding those verses. So inshallah azza wa jal, we are going to discuss what we left in the last silsila, and that was the verse number 84 and 85 in Surah Baqarah. We discussed أَفَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِبَعْدِ الْكِتَابِ وَتَكْفُرُونَ بِبَعْدِ. Today I am going to ask Mufti Sahab another question, and that is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has described a punishment that فَمَا جَزَاءُ مَنْ يَفْعَلُ ذَلِكَ مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا خِزْيٌ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ يُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ أَشَدِّ الْعَذَابِ. Translation: so what else is the recompense for one who does so among you except humiliation in the life of this world, and on the day of judgment they will be returned to severe punishment, and Allah is not unaware of their actions. Reviewers of Madri channel, my today's question, the first question is going to be that can this punishment come to us as well? And then the second question which I'm going to ask Mufti Sahab, that what is the reason that sometimes people, they act upon some of the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they left some others. So Mufti Sahab, what would you say in response to these two questions?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allah azza wa jal has revealed Quran towards us for our guidance. So whatever Allah azza wa jal has mentioned in the Holy Quran, there would be admonition for us. There would be some guidance and some instructions or some commandments. So when Allah Azza wa Jalla describes some stories of previous nations, so it means there are some lessons for us. Similarly, in this story, Allah Azza wa Jalla describes the behavior and attitude of Bani Israel regarding the commandments of Allah Azza wa Jalla. What did they do in their life? Allah Azza wa Jal granted them three commandments and they followed one of them, and they remained neglectful about two. So then Allah Azza wa Jal described their recompense, their punishment. And what was that which Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned here? فَمَا جَزَاءُ مَنْ يَفْعَلُ ذَلِكَ مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا خِزْيٌ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ يُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ أَشَدِّ الْعَذَابِ. There are two punishments. One, they will be afflicted with humiliation in this world. And the second, they will face punishment on the day of judgment, meaning they will be thrown into hellfire and they will face that punishment. So now, as we have discussed, our attitudes, mean the attitude of Muslim community is like them. So that punishment would apply to Muslims or not? So, because Allah Azza wa Jal has described that punishment to us so that we can get some lesson and we can rectify ourselves. So, it means if we adopt that behavior and that attitude regarding commandments of Allah Azza wa Jal, so we will have to face that punishment and we will have to face that recompense. So, as far as the first punishment is concerned, means humiliation in this world, so we can look at the conditions of Muslim, how is that? How honorable they are considered in the world? We know very well that Muslims as a nation, as a community, they are not respectable, they are not honorable people in the world. They are humiliated, they are disregarded, and they are dishonored in the eyes of the people. So that punishment we are observing with our open eyes. Now the second punishment, وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ يُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ أَشَدِّ الْعَذَابِ. So that is in the power of Allah Azza wa Jal. Whatever Allah Azza wa Jal will do with us, Allah knows better. But as far as the punishment of this world is concerned, so we are observing that with our own eyes. So now the second question, what is the reason? What is the reason for that negligence and that heedlessness? So basically the reason is also this, that the reason of avoiding the commandments of Allah Azza wa Jal and not practicing the commandment of Allah Azza wa Jal is to be heedless about commandments of Allah Azza wa Jal. And the reason behind that is love with this world, is love of seeking worldly wealth. As Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned in the Holy Quran, Al-haakumut takathur hatta zurtumul maqabir. Seeking of abundant wealth has diverted you from the remembrance of Allah, from the commandments of Allah Azza wa Jal. Till when? Hatta zurtumul maqabir. Until you visited graveyard, mean death came to you. Means till your death, you remain neglectful, you remain heedless, and you remain in that condition. So seeking worldly wealth abundantly, that is one of the main reasons of this negligence. Then in another ayah, Allah Azza wa Jal had described, and Allah Azza wa Jal has commanded us about that. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu la tulhikum amwalukum wala awladukum an dhikrillah wa man yaf'al dhalika fa ulaika humul khasirun. O believers, let not your wealth and your children divert you from the remembrance of Allah. Wa man yaf'al dhalika, and whosoever will do so, فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ, they are the losers, they will be losers. So what is that loss? That loss is the same thing. فَمَا جَزَاءُ مَنْ يَفْعَلُ ذَلِكَ مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا خِزْيٌ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ يُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ أَشَدِّ الْعَذَابِ. So that loss is humiliation in this world and punishment on the day of judgment. So now in this ayah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُلْهِكُمْ أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُكُمْ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, in this ayah, Allah Azza wa Jal has openly commanded us to be away from negligence, from heedlessness, and Allah Azza wa Jal has made us aware of the harms of this worldly wealth and the love of our children and love of this worldly wealth. And who will not act upon that commandment of Allah Azza wa Jal, so what would be his end? What would be the result? So Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned, وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ, and whosoever will do so, they are the losers. So that loss we are bearing, and that loss we are facing, and that loss we are observing with our eyes. So that humiliation we are observing, and the punishment on the day of judgment. So may Allah forgive us from that punishment. So the reason behind that is seeking worldly wealth, being indulged in the love of world and worldly wealth, that is the reason. So if we have to get rid of this disease and this problem, so then we have to get rid of love with worldly wealth first, then we can rectify ourselves and then we can get rid of this humiliation.
Reviewers of Madri Channel, the root cause of the problem, according to Mufti Saab, in the light of Quran and Hadith, is our love for the world, our attachment with the world. And because of this love of the world, Muslims are in trouble, problem and humiliation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant strength to the Muslim Ummah again. Moving to the next question, the verse, وَآتَيْنَا عِيسَى ابْنَ مَرْيَمَ الْبَيِّنَاتِ وَأَيَّدْنَاهُ بِرُوحِ الْقُدُسِ. Translation, we granted Isa the son of Maryam clear signs and aided him through the pure spirit. The viewers of Madri Channel, in this verse, word Ruhul Quds is used. So we have to understand what is the meaning of Ruhul Quds, and then in which way that Ruhul Quds or the pure spirit aids or helps or supports Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. And then I would also like to ask Mufti Saab, that can Jibreel Amin alayhi salatu wasalam help the Muslims?
Allah Azza wa Jal has described Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam as Ruhul Qudus in this place. And so Ruhul Qudus means the soul of purity, the spirit of purity. And that is the title of Hazrat Jibreel Amin alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah Azza wa Jal has given many titles to Jibreel Amin alayhi salatu wasalam. as one title is Amin, one title is Muta'in, one title is Ruhul Amin. That is another title of Hazrat Jibrail alayhi salatu wasalam. So Allah Azza wa Jal granted mujizat and bayyinat, clear sign to Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. So now in this place Allah Azza wa Jal has said that we spotted Isa alayhi salatu wasalam through Jibrail alayhi salatu wasalam. So Jibrail Amin alayhi salatu wasalam used to stay with Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam since his birth. Means since the birth of Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, Jibrail Amin alayhi salatu wasalam stayed with him. And at the time of the ascension of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, when Jews tried to crucify Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, so at that time, Allah Azza wa Jal uplifted Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam towards skies, and that was on the wings of Jibrail Amin alayhi salatu wasalam. And throughout the life of Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, Jibrail Amin alayhi salatu wasalam used to support Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Even about the birth of Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, what Allah Azza wa Jal have mentioned in the Holy Quran, in Surah Maryam and in other surahs, Allah Azza wa Jal has said, فَتَمَثَّلَ لَهَا بَشَرًا سَوِيًّا. Jibrail alayhi salatu wasalam appeared in the form of a man before Hazrat Maryam, and he blew over Hazrat Maryam radiyallahu ta'ala anha, and Hazrat Maryam radiyallahu ta'ala anha got pregnant. So that was the procedure of the birth of Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Means before the time of the birth of Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, Jibrail Amin alayhi salatu wasalam supported Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. So Jibrail Amin alayhi salatu wasalam can support, he can help the people. So as Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned in this place, وَأَيَّدَنَهُ بِرُوحِ الْقُدُسِ, we supported Isa alayhi salatu wasalam through Jibrail Amin alayhi salatu wasalam. So support of Allah Azza wa Jalla sometimes come through the beloved people to Allah Azza wa Jal, through Jibrail alayhi salatu wasalam, through other angels, as in the battle of Badr, Allah Azza wa Jal has supported Muslim army with angels. 5,000 angels were sent down for the support of Muslims. So they were sent down and they supported Muslims. So means angels and Jibrail alayhi salatu wasalam, they can support Muslim and they can support other. And as far as, and particularly the support of Jibrail Amin alayhi salatu wasalam, so Allah Azza wa Jal granted that support of Jibrail Amin alayhi salatu wasalam to other people as well. As in the hadith of Bukhari Sharif, Hazrat Hassan bin Sabit radiyallahu ta'ala anhu was a Naat reciter. He was the shayr of the court of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he used to defend the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam against infidels, because infidels, disbelievers, They used to condemn the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with their poetry. There were many poets who were Sahaba, and they used to defend the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But particularly, Sayyiduna Hassan bin Sabit radiallahu ta'ala anhu was prominent among them. So he used to defend the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say to Hassan bin Sabit radiallahu ta'ala anhu to stand upon the member of the pulpit of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to defend the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam against infidel. So that was his routine to defend. So once Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam blessed him with his supplication in the court of Allah, Allahumma ayyidhu bi ruhil qudus, O Allah, support Hassan bin Sabit through Jibrail Amin alayhi salatu wasallam, through ruhul qudus, O Allah, support Hazrat Hassan bin Sabit radiyallahu ta'ala. So in this hadith and according to this ayah, we can say Jibrail Amin alayhi salatu wasalam can help other.
Subhanallah. The viewers of Madni channel, those who are busy in the praise of beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, either composing or reciting, they are in the shade of help of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And from the hadith which Mufti Sahab mentioned, it shows that Aqad Alam sallallahu alayhi wasallam likes those people who praise him, who write naat for him and recite naat for him. But it is as long as that recitation of naat and composing of naat is within the boundaries of Sharia. Moving to the next question. قُلْ إِنْ كَانَتْ لَكُمُ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَالِصَةً مِّن دُونِ النَّاسِ فَتَمَنَّوُ الْمَوْتَ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ وَلَنْ يَتَمَنَّوهُ أَبَدًا بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِالظَّالِمِينَ. Translation: O beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, say, if the abode of afterlife with Allah is solely for you, excluding other people, then yearn for death if you are truthful. and they will never long for death due to their transgression, and Allah is the well aware of the oppressors. The viewers of Madri channel, in this verse of Holy Quran, some people are being addressed and they are being commanded that they must wish for death, they must long for death. Now let's ask Mufti Sahab that in which context these people are being commanded to wish for death, and then what is the ruling of Sharia if any Muslim wishes for death, longs for death?
First of all, I would say this siga means this sentence fataman nabul mauta. Basically, that is not commandment. Meaning that was not demanded from them to wish for death. That was only to embarrass them. And there is a context behind that making them embarrassed. What was that? They used to claim, we are the only people who will enter into paradise. When they claimed, they will be only people who will enter into paradise, Allah Azza wa Jal said to them, if you are claiming that the hereafter, mean paradise, is only for you in the court of Allah, not for any other person, so then fatamanna wal maut, so you should wish for death. In kuntum sadiqi, if you are truthful, because when you are claiming that paradise is only for us and we must enter into paradise, so why are you facing the difficulties of this world? Why are you facing the hardships of this world? Why are you being afflicted with the problems of this world? You should wish for death so that you can die and you can enter into that paradise and you get the bounties of Allah Azza wa Jal there. So, but they didn't wish. As Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned in this place, وَلَنْ يَتَمَنَّوْهُ أَبَدًا بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ. They will never ever wish for death because of their misdeeds. بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ, because of their misdeeds, they will never ever wish for death. One sahabi, one companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam once said, if they had wished for death, they would have been eliminated from this world. So they didn't wish. So now there is another point. Allah Azza wa Jal said to them, wish for death. And then Allah Azza wa Jal told in the same place, they will never ever wish for death. That was one kind of news. And that news was about unseen matter, about future. Now if they wished to counter the news of Allah Azza wa Jal, so they could wish, but they didn't do that. Allah Azza wa Jal told about unseen matter that they will never ever wish for death, and really they didn't wish for death. So now the second question, as they were demanded to wish for death, so are we allowed to wish for death if we are in trouble, if we are facing hardships, as it happened, the people do suicide and they kill their own selves. So are we allowed to wish for death? There might be two kinds of that wish. If that wish is because of worldly matter and because of worldly problems and troubles and inconveniences, if that is because of that, so then it is not allowed. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has forbidden from that. Yeah, if a person is in trouble and he thinks that because of this trouble might be my deen, my religion would be affected. So for that purpose, he could wish with these words which have been mentioned in hadith, oh Allah, if my life is better for me, keep me alive. And if death is better for me, so then cause me to die. So in these words, a person can wish, means he can pray in the court of Allah Azza wa Jal. Otherwise, we are not allowed to wish for death. We have to show patience. We have to have trust in Allah Azza wa Jal. We have to face the hardships of the life, and we have to abstain from sin, and we have to get more and more virtues. That is the commandment of Allah Azza wa Jal. Because wishing for death is against patience, and that is against having trust in Allah Azza wa Jal. And that is against being satisfied with the will of Allah Azza wa Jal. That is against Raza bil Qaza. So that's why we are not allowed to wish for death. Yeah, there are some narrations in which Sahaba Ikram or some other people, they wished for death. As about Hadrat Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he used to supplicate in the court of Allah, Allahumma rzuqni shahadatan fi sabilik waj'al mawti fi balati rasulik. Oh Allah, grant me shahadat in your path. And O Allah, make my death in the blessed city of your holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. So in his words, it is being supplicated, O Allah, grant me shahadat in your path. That is not wish for death. That is wish for shahadat in the meaning that whenever I depart this world, so I depart this world on your path, and I will be given the death of shahadat. So that prayer is about shahadat. That is not wish for death. Then there are some other narrations in which really there is wish for death, but really in those narrations, those desires are desires for getting the pleasure of Allah, for getting shahada. As Sayyidina Khalid bin Walid radiallahu ta'ala sent message to a ruler of a country, Kisra or Kaisar. So Sayyidina Khalid bin Walid radiallahu ta'ala sent message that with me there is a nation who love death more than you love alcohol. So they love death more than that. So their love with death for getting shahada or for getting the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal. So if for that purpose someone loves death or someone wishes death, that after death I will be present in the court of Allah Azza wa Jal, or I will have the vision of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam in my grave. So if for getting that barakah and the vision of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam, if someone wishes for death, that is allowed. That is not forbidden. Forbidden is only that condition in which a person, because of the hardships of the world, he wishes for death. That is not allowed.
Subhanallah. The viewers of Madrin channel, Muslims are not allowed to wish for death because of the hardships of the life. Meaning when one gets fed up with his very existence in this world, and he is in lot of difficulties and problems and facing hardships of the world, and now because of these hardships he wants to depart this world, he wants to wish for death, then it is not allowed. But if one is wishing for death because in this way he will be able to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he will be able to make ziyarat of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so because of these good purposes it is allowed for him to wish for death. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq to be practicing Muslim and to act upon the commandments of Sharia. Sallu alal habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.